done earlier, pictorial representation.
Sir, please on the recording.
Yes. Yes, I have done.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So this is pictorial representation, which I have explained earlier. And when two amino acids join together, or they are forming an amide, which is shown here. That we have done all earlier. So I'm going a little bit fast so that we can complete the topic. Then third molecule joining with amide, we are getting diamide, and then more monomers, more amino acids or more monomers are joining together, resulting in a macromolecule which is known as polyamide. That is the polymer of wool fiber. And this is having polyamide links. And here we have shown this in a particular configuration, and this is known as keratin. So this is one macromolecule or one polymer of wool, which is named as keratin, that we have done in the last class. Then polymer system. In polymer system, we have taken wool polymer is a linear keratin polymer with some very short side groups. बेटा किसी का unmute है कहा कहा is creating disturbance, so please keep muted yourself. And normally has a helical configuration, and this helical configuration is known as alpha keratin, which I have shown you with the help of diagram also. And these are different type, different amino 18 type of amino acids are found in wool, in which three are important: arginine, cysteine, glutamic. And the length of the wool polymer is 140 nm and thickness is 1 nm. Then important chemical groupings. First is hydrogen bonding that we have covered in the last class. And here it is shown when the two polymer chains are coming closer, and by chance this oxygen of this polymer chain and hydrogen is coming near, and the approximately 26 to 28 nm, then the hydrogen bond is formed. Hydrogen bonds may be limited due to bulky side groups, because wool is having bulky side groups, and that's why the distance between these two polymers may be more than this, and that's why formation of hydrogen bonds will be maybe less in case of wool fibers. That we have covered earlier. Now we were doing this one, salt linkages, how the salt linkages are formed. So we will repeat it again. This bond results due to electrostatic attraction of positively and negatively charged ions, which are shown here. This is negatively charged ion and this is positively charged ion. In keratin molecule, few amino acids have free amino groups, which are shown here, and few have free acid groups, COOH. When the basic and acidic, this is acidic group and this is basic group, when the basic and acidic groups will come closer, they will neutralize each other, because one is negatively charged, another is positively charged. When they come closer, they will neutralize each other, and when they neutralize each other, we are getting a salt. So formation of salt is there, and due to this, these linkages or these bonds are known as salt linkages. The acidic part will lose one hydrogen atom. COOH is losing one hydrogen atom, so we are having COO, and it is negatively charged and become negatively charged. The basic part will acquire one hydrogen atom. This NH2 is acquiring one hydrogen atom and become positively charged, and they will be connected together by electrostatic forces. So due to this negative and positive charges, electrostatic forces will develop, and that will keep it connected. And that's why this is also known as electrovalent bond or ionic bond. So these salt linkages are also known as electrovalent or ionic bonds. Another type of bonding present in wool is known as cysteine bonds or cysteine linkages. Cysteine, the sulfur containing amino acid, which is present in wool, and that is the specialty of the wool, which is not found in silk. This is a specialty of wool, particularly in the polyamide fibers, which is having cysteine. One of the amino acid is having cysteine. Cysteine is the name of amino acid. So this cysteine is containing sulfur. So cysteine is the name of amino acid which is containing sulfur. Cysteine, the sulfur containing amino acid which is present in wool, makes the wool polymer system the only one with cysteine linkages or cysteine bonds, also known as disulfide bonds and more commonly known as covalent bonds. How it is formed, that can be seen here. Cysteine contains two acid groups and two amino groups. The cysteine, which is the name of particular amino acid found only in wool, is having two acid groups and two amino groups. A single molecule of cysteine can thus be involved in two separate protein chains, which is shown here. This is one polymer chain and this is another polymer chain. And here you have the sulfur S. This S is indicating sulfur content. So this sulfur content here is joining these two polymer chains here. So this can be done by condensation with other amino acids, and thus pair of these groups is in one chain and the other pair is in another chain. One is here and one is here. So ek is chain mein work kar raha hai, ek is chain mein work kar raha, because it is having two acid groups and two amino groups. That's why they are connecting with one polymer chain here and one polymer chain here. In this cysteine linkages, covalent bond is formed, which is more resistant than electrovalent bond. That is salt linkages. And these cross links will give additional strength or rigidity to the fiber. So here you can see this one chain is here and one chain and this another chain. So this sulfur content is joining this chain, and also here the sulfur content is joining this, and these two are resulting in cysteine bonds or covalent bonds. So these three types of bonds are dominating in the wool fiber, but it is also containing van der Waals forces. Wherever the distance is lesser than 5 nanometer, then van der Waals forces are formed. So very little van der Waals forces of attraction are found in wool polymer system. So total 4 types of bonds, but mainly covalent, these cysteine links and salt linkages are the dominating bond in wool fiber, but a few number of hydrogen bonds and van der Waals forces are also occurring in wool fiber. So these 4 types of chemical groupings of interpolymer forces of attraction are found in the polymer system of wool fiber. Now about the something about the polymer system. This should be visualized as helical polymers spiraling about each other. That I have already shown in the diagram, and again we will take later on. I will show the diagram again. Like coils coiling about themselves. It will be better we take the diagram here. Like coils coiling with themselves, and this is known as helical configuration that is given here. So this should be visualized as helical polymers spiraling about each other. Like coils coiling about themselves. This is configuration of wool polymer system. Means how the polymers are arranged in wool fiber. In addition, spiraling ke alawa, this coiling ke alawa kya hai? In addition, there is distinct order of spiraling in which each protofibril consists of 3 alpha keratin polymers spiraling about each other. The order of spiraling continues up to macrofibrils. The polymer system of wool is this paragraph is related with morphological structure. Do you remember morphological structure? Or I will show you again. Yes, this keratin polymer, this wool polymer, is for number of 3 wool polymers are forming protofibril. 11 protofibrils are forming 1 microfibril, and hundreds of microfibrils are forming macrofibril, and these are spiraling with each other. That is the meaning of that paragraph. In addition, there is distinct order of spiraling. in which each protofibril consists of three alpha keratin polymers. Ye jo alpha keratin polymers hai, they are spiraling about each other, then protofibrils are spiraling, and this order of spiraling continues up to macrofibrils, microfibrils, and then microfibrils. So this polymer system is having a coil like structures. The polymer system of wool is extremely amorphous. That is the point which you have to remember, because it is going to affect the strength and many other properties. Like cotton is a crystalline fiber, but wool is considered as amorphous fiber because it is having more amorphous region. It is about 25 to 30% crystalline and correspondingly 75 to 70% amorphous. If it is 25% crystalline, then 75% amorphous. 30% crystalline, then 70% amorphous. So you can see 70 to 75% areas are of amorphous regions. And that's why wool fiber is termed as amorphous fiber, or it can be categorized as amorphous fiber. This arrangement already I have shown. The molecules are arranged in, the polymers are arranged in helical configuration, means spiraling with each other. Yes, you can note down the important amino acids found in wool. These are the main amino acids. Total 18 are there, but the main ratio, the main proportion is of these amino acids known as glycine, alamine, tyrosine, lysine, glutamic, cysteine, and arginine. These are the important amino acids found in wool fiber among the 18 amino acids. Here you can see a comparison of type of name of amino acids and percentage of their proportion of their found in wool and silk, because wool and silk both are protein fiber, means polyamide fibers. So here they are formed from amino acids. So in wool, a list of amino acids found in wool is given here, and a percentage of in found in percentage of amino acids found in wool is given here, and percentage of amino acids found in silk is given here. That is not very important. Just for your knowledge, I have shared this slide. Then chemical composition. Chemical composition of wool is shown here. The wool sheared from the sheep consists of considerable amount of impurities. जो wool, जो fleece हमें मिल रही है, उसमें काफी amount में impurities होती हैं, and that the proportion is given here. The keratin, which is the polymerous material, the fibrous material, is 45 to 75%. Varies between 45 to 75%. You can see huge gap is there, means different wool is having different composition and very high percentage of impurities may be there. In that case, keratin will be very less. But when in a good quality of wool, keratin is 75%, then impurities will be less. Then impurities found in this is grease 5 to 15%, moisture 10 to 12%. Soint 2 to 12%, sand and dirt 4 to 30%, and vegetable matter 0.5, 0 to 5. So not 0.5, it is 0 to 5. So we will take slight little bit details of these impurities. So first we are taking grease. Wool grease is an ester of high molecular weight fatty acids. What type of grease is found in this is given here. It is an ester of high molecular weight fatty acids and a monohydric alcohol. This is a wax. It is soluble in organic solvents. So if we have to remove this grease, and we have to remove this, it can be removed by solving the wool fiber into organic solvents. So that grease is grease is soluble in organic solvent, so it will get dissolved and we will get a pure wool fiber. So it consists of potassium salts of fatty acids and organic amino acids. This is soluble in water and can be isolated from the raw wool by aqueous extraction. So if we have to for the removal of soint, we are doing this process. It is soluble in water, so it will be dissolved in water and can be isolated or can be removed from the raw wool by aqueous extraction. Sand, dirt, and vegetable matter, which are foreign impurities in the wool fiber, these are held by adhesive action of the grease and falls away when the latter is removed during scoring. Scoring ke time pe jab hum isko remove kar dete hain grease ko aur inko, So automatically, because they are adhered due to this grease, so grease जब remove होगा तो automatically sand, dirt and vegetable matters will get removed. Keratin, the purified wool consists of keratin which contains protein, and the content, the elements found in a different proportion here in protein or keratin is carbon is 50 to 53%, hydrogen is 6 to 7%, nitrogen is 16 to 18%, oxygen is 21 to 25%, and sulfur, which is resulting in cystine bones, is 0.7 to 5%. So this is chemical composition of keratin found in wool fiber. And above we have taken the chemical composition of wool fiber. So chemical composition of wool fiber, you have to answer this one: grease, suint, sand, and keratin. If it is asked that what is the chemical composition of keratin found in wool fiber, then the answer will be this. So don't get confused. It is a chemical composition of keratin, which is one element of wool fiber. So one composition of wool fiber. So if it is asked, explain chemical composition of wool fiber, this will be the answer. This slide and this slide will be the answer. If it is asked what is the chemical composition of keratin found in wool, then you have to answer this much only. So in this way we have covered today's topic. And the remaining